In this video, I will show you how to replace the body control module or BCM in a 4th generation Kia Sportage. The BCM is one of the key electronic modules in your vehicle. It manages and controls a variety of systems, including your power windows, door locks, interior lights, wipers, and even parts of the communication network between other control units. If you're facing electrical issues like lights not working properly, windows acting up, gear shifter stuck in park, or intermittent communication errors when scanning for fault codes, the BCM could be the culprit. In 4th generation Sportage, the BCM is located behind the glove box area. So to access it, we will first have to remove the glove box housing and a few surrounding panels. Safety first, disconnect the negative terminal of the battery. Start by taking off the crash pad under cover beneath the glove box. Press the two locking tabs near the front edge and pull the cover downward. Then slide it toward you to release it from its rear hooks. Next, open the glove box and take out all the items inside. Now look for small plastic stoppers located on both sides inside the glove box. To remove them, grip each stopper and twist it counterclockwise until it unlocks. Then pull it straight out. Next, move to the damper arm on the side of the glove box. This small linkage controls how smoothly the glove box opens and closes. Gently unclip the damper arm by pulling it outward from its mounting point. Once that's done, carefully tilt the glove box downward. You will now see two hinge pins attached near the bottom of the glove box. Push the end of each pin and slide it outward. With the pins removed, the glove box will detach completely from the dashboard. From this opening, you can actually see the body control module beside the HVAC housing. Before you can remove the glove box housing, you will first have to take off the long trim piece that runs across the dashboard, also called the crash pad garnish. However, before you can remove this trim, you will have to loosen the top cover of the center console first. Start by ensuring the parking brake is engaged or place wheel chocks at one of the tires for added safety. Next, use a flathead screwdriver to carefully pry off the shift lock release button cap. Press the release button and move the gear shifter into the neutral position. This will create more working space around the console area. Now move to the rear section of the center console, near the armrest. Gently pull upward on the panel to loosen it. As you lift, you will hear a few clips popping loose. You do not have to remove it completely, just lift it slightly to provide enough clearance to free the dashboard trim. Once the console cover is raised, you will have enough room to safely remove the long trim. Now move to the passenger side of the dashboard. There's a small side panel near the door that hides a screw holding the long trim in place. Begin by gently pulling back the rubber weather strip along the door frame, just enough to uncover the edge of the side panel. Next, insert a plastic trim removal tool or a flathead screwdriver inside the small notch near the bottom of the panel. Carefully pry it outward while applying steady, even pressure. The panel is held in by several clips, so you feel them pop loose as it comes off. Once the side panel is removed, you will spot a screw near the upper corner of the dashboard. Use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove the screw. The long trim is secured with several clips along its length. Start on the passenger side, where you will find two clips near the edge. Use a plastic trim tool to gently release those first. Slide the tool behind the tabs and carefully pry outward. Once the side clips are released, continue working your way along the entire length of the trim piece, unclipping each section as you go. Be patient and use gentle, even pressure to avoid bending or cracking the trim. After all the clips have been disengaged, remove the trim and place it somewhere safe where it will not get scratched. With the long trim piece out of the way, you can now move on to removing the glove box housing. The glove box housing is secured to the dashboard with a combination of screws and bolts that you will have to remove. There are two screws along the top edge, three screws on the side, and four 10mm bolts along the bottom edge. Use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove all five screws. Then use a 10mm socket wrench to remove all four bolts near the bottom edge. Once all the screws and bolts have been removed, the glove box housing will still be secured by several plastic retaining clips. The housing is also secured with a side clip. Use a plastic trim tool or a flathead screwdriver to gently release that clip before pulling out the housing. With the side clip released, grip the glove box housing firmly with both hands and pull it straight towards you. You will feel each clip pop loose one by one as you apply pressure. Be careful not to pull the housing too hard. There are wiring harnesses connected behind it. At the top of the housing, you will see the glove box light. This light does not use a regular plug type connector. Instead, it has two individual wires that slide directly onto the light's metal terminals. Because of this design, it's much easier to remove the light itself rather than trying to disconnect the wires. Simply push the light downward and it will pop right off its socket. Then move it out of the way. The glove box housing is also hooked and clipped into the side trim. Unclip that side first by pushing the housing trim inward while gently pulling the side trim outward. You'll feel the clip release from the trim. After it pops free, lift that side of the housing slightly to unhook it from the trim. At this point, the housing is loose, but it is still connected by the glove box light switch harness located near the bottom edge. Make sure to disconnect this before taking the housing out completely. Press the release tab on the side of the connector and pull it straight out. Now the housing is fully disconnected and you can remove it from the vehicle. With the glove box housing removed, we now have clear access to the body control module or BCM mounted on the side of the HVAC housing, right next to the cabin air filter compartment. The mounting bracket of the body control module is held in place by two 10mm nuts which are clearly visible and easily accessible. However, there is one more screw mounted near the bottom of the BCM bracket which is a little towards the inside. Due to the tight space in that area, you will have to use a small stubby Phillips head screwdriver like this one to remove the screw. Before removing the body control module, start by disconnecting its electrical connectors. There are four connectors in total. One in the front and three at the bottom, each secured with a locking tab. Press down on the tab and gently pull each connector straight out. Take your time here. Avoid pulling on the wires themselves to prevent any damage. After disconnecting all the connectors, use your stubby Phillips head screwdriver to remove the screw near the bottom of the BCM mounting bracket. Then use a 10mm socket wrench to remove the two nuts. Then carefully pull the BCM out from its mounting position. Be mindful of any nearby wiring harnesses as you remove it from the housing. The metal bracket of the BCM can cut the insulation on the wires if you are not careful. The BCM is blocked by this wiring harness for the blower motor, so we will have to unclip it first. Squeeze the inside of the clip using a pick tool, then pull the clip out. With the wiring harness out of the way, we can now safely remove the BCM from the vehicle. Here is a close-up of the body control module. This is the part number. Keep in mind the part number on your vehicle may be different depending on the model year and trim level. Now take your new BCM and carefully align it with the mounting bracket. Then hand tighten the two nuts onto the struts to hold the BCM in position. Then tighten them down using a 10mm socket. Make sure it is tight, but do not over tighten. Then reinstall the single screw near the bottom to firmly secure the module. Make sure the BCM is fully secured and not loose. Once the BCM is mounted, reconnect all four electrical connectors. Push each connector in until you hear or feel a click, confirming it's properly locked in. Double check that every connector is fully seated to avoid any communication issues later. With that done, you can put everything back together. Carefully position the glove box housing back into the dashboard. Start by reconnecting the electrical connector for the glove box light switch. Press it in firmly until you hear or feel it click into place. Next, lift the side of the housing and slide the hook back into the side trim. Make sure the hook is fully seated so the housing lines up correctly with the rest of the dashboard. Once the hook is engaged, reinstall the glove box light at the top. Then guide the housing back into its original position. Gently push the housing toward the dashboard. Make sure the edges sit evenly. Keep pressing the housing until all the clips snap into position. Make sure the housing is also clipped into the side trim. Firmly press the side trim into the housing tab until you hear a clicking noise. Next, reinstall the screws and bolts. Two screws at the top, three screws on the side, and four bolts near the bottom. Next, reinstall the long dashboard trim. Position the trim along the dashboard, aligning it with its mounting points. Press firmly along the length of the trim to engage all the clips. Apply a steady, even pressure to avoid cracking or bending the trim and to ensure it sits flush against the dashboard. Once all the clips are fully engaged, reinstall the screw on the side of the dashboard to secure the trim. Next, take the small side panel and carefully align it with its mounting points on the dashboard. Gently press it into place until all the retaining clips engage and you feel it sit firmly and flush against the surrounding trim. After the side panel is secured, carefully press the rubber weather strip back into its original position. Make sure it is seated properly. Next, reinstall the center console upper cover. Position the cover back over the top of the center console, aligning it with the mounting points. Gently press down along the edges to engage the clips. Make sure the cover sits evenly and flush with the surrounding panels with no gaps. Now it's time to reinstall the glove box itself. Start by aligning the glove box with the hinge mounts at the bottom. Slide the hinge pins back into place. Just push them straight in until they lock securely. Next, reconnect the damper arm on the side. Align the hole on the damper arm with the mounting point on the glove box and snap it back into position. This ensures the glove box opens and closes smoothly. Reinstall the stoppers inside the glove box by inserting them into their holes and twisting them clockwise until they lock in place. Open and close the glove box a few times to make sure everything is operating smoothly. Finally, put the crash pad undercover back in place. Start by sliding the rear hooks into their slots. Once the hooks are in place, lift the front of the cover and push upward until both locking tabs snap into place. And that's how you replace the body control module, or BCM, in a 4th generation Kia Sportage. Keep in mind that body control module is not a plug and play component. You will have to reprogram the new module using a compatible OBD scanner. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to WeezeGiant for more helpful DIY automotive repair guides. Thanks for watching.